Weight Loss MD and Wellness of Upper Plaza Kenosha. Hey, you got a weight loss question? Right now, 262-694-1050. Joining us from Weight Loss MD and Wellness, Cheri Stoka. Good morning.
Good morning. How are you doing?
We're doing good. We're into the rain barrel for weight loss questions this morning, and I know that Mr. Question Man has been a very, very busy bee, which I guess leads us to the first question there, Mr. Question
Man.
Wow,
look at you clicking on all cylinders today. Yes, our first question asker wants to know, I think, about natural sweeteners, specifically honey, asking, is it better to use honey than processed sugar? And asking straight up, is it the healthier option, Cheri?
Yeah, so great question. Yes. Absolutely. Honey is probably the best option. You know, also factoring in that it still is a sugar, so it can have an effect on blood sugars and that type of thing. But honey has so many health benefits. I mean, it's like antimicrobial. It has a ton of antioxidants. It actually has so many other uses. I mean, there's a couple studies that were done that shows if you put honey on like wounds or ulcers, like it's incredible, healing powers. So yes,
wow.
Honey, just kind of watch the amount, just because of, you know, again, the blood sugars, but yes, definitely a better alternative.
Now, actual honey, not like Honey Nut Cheerios or something like that.
Thanks for pointing that out, because the very important piece is that it has to be honey, like in the raw honey, because a lot of these processed honeys in the grocery store are GMO, synthetic, and things like that. So make sure, I mean, you can actually go to get it fresh from, you know, local honey farms, which is amazing.
That's the best way to go. All right, number two, Mr.
Yeah.
Question Man.
Well, it's kind of connected to that last comment. What are some foods that are marketed as healthy but are not?
Well,
Where to start, right?
Really difficult question, because really, you know, I'm always looking for, you know, healthier options. And then when I turn the box over and I look at the ingredients, I look at the added sugar, and, you know, oftentimes it's not a healthy food. So I think rather than, you know, pointing out specific foods because it's just so massive, I think, again, just really doing some further, you know, investigation on the label and looking at how many ingredients are in that product, how many additives, preservatives, added sugars. All those pieces are very important, you know, because if you're, again, buying food that is whole, it's not going to really require any labels. So, you know, kind of taking that approach, I think, is much better.
A couple of things jump into my mind, Cheri. One is granola bars, and the other one is yogurts. A couple of things you really got to read labels on, because they can have a lot of extra stuff.
You brought up Cheerios straight up.
Cheerios,
I mean, they're marketed as a heart-healthy product, so.
Yeah, and that couldn't be further from the truth. I know, and those two examples, you know, the granola bar and the yogurt, those are perfect examples, because they're really just glorified sugar, you know? I mean, it's a granola bar, half of them are just they're equivalent to a candy bar.
Right.
So, you know, kind of watching that, yeah.
So, read your labels. Lesson learned.
So eat the Snickers instead of the granola bar.
No, don't do that.
No, don't do that.
Have a tomato.
There you go.
All right. Once in a while, I like to go out to eat. What's the next question, Mr. Question Man?
What are some strategies for ordering healthy in a restaurant?
Yeah, okay. So I would say, like, first, which is kind of common sense, is, you know, when you're going into a restaurant, of course, you know, if it's fast food, it's going to be difficult to just find something healthier. But if you're going to a sit-down restaurant, I would say some tips are really looking for, you know, staying away from the high carbohydrate meals. So the pasta, the pizza, you know, I mean, of course, those things are going to be consumed and they're fine in moderation. But I always tell people, you know, if you're going to have like a hamburger or a pizza or something like that, just eat half of it and order some type of vegetable. But of course, you know, making sure that the vegetables aren't doused in, you know, oils and sauces. So just, I know that's like probably sounds like overwhelming to go and try to like figure all this out, but I tell people, like, always just add a vegetable or have like a salad before, so you're not, you know, you're not so hungry before your meal comes.
I think too, Cheri, a lot of restaurants are now becoming more accommodating to people who are on diets. You're getting more vegetarian, vegan selections. But you still, and again, another thing too is don't be afraid to ask for what you want at a restaurant. Most of the time, they'll try to accommodate you.
Yeah, absolutely, especially with this growing number of people that have food sensitivities. You know, gluten-free people, a lot of people are gluten-free, so you ask for no sauces. So they absolutely will accommodate, you know, specific requests. So that's a very good point.
Yeah, don't be afraid to ask. People go, oh, well, no, I'm not going to make a stink. You know, they'll be more than happy to help you with your situation. Now, if you have a situation, Wayless MD and Wellness is ready to help you solve it. And the first visit is absolutely free, Cheri Stoka.
Yes, we can be reached at 262-226-2046.
And check out the website, waylessmd.com. Check out the podcast on your favorite Spotify platform, weighing in with Wayless MD. She is Cheri Stoka. Southport Plaza, Wayless, MD and Wellness. Cheri, thanks as always. Keep those questions coming, folks. We want to fill up that rain barrel for next week. Have a great week, Cheri.